So hello everyone, once again.
I need to give some permissions. It's strange.
What, sorry?
Okay. It was some window. I guess everybody saw it. It's that. So I give permission to record. It was something extra. I did not notice. Okay. So.
Okay. It was like probably it. Because I started the recording. Yeah. So our speaker today is Iskander Kalimulin from Kazan Federal University. And the title of the talk is Punctual Categoricity and Degrees of Punctual Categoricity for Finitely Generated Structures. Please, Iskander.
Okay, thanks. Thanks, Katya. Thanks for organizers for inviting me. Thanks for a possibility to practice English, because being in Kazan for 1 year or more, I guess my English became worse than usual. So sorry for that. Today I will speak about the effect of categoricity among punctual or primitive recursive algorithms in algebraic structures. So under punctual, usually I understand just a primitive recursive. It's almost the same as primitive recursive, but only with one important restriction. A structure A is punctual or fully primitive recursive if the domain is either the set of all natural numbers, or it's just to include the finite structures in the definition, we allow the domain to be automatic, so it is a regular language. And all relations and operations in the structure must be primitive recursive. So there are some several reasons why we distinct why we consider two definitions, punctual and primitive recursive. But I will not speak today about that. It's just a lot of recent publications studies exactly the punctual presentation. So a punctual presentation of a countable structure is any punctual isomorphic copy of the structure A. So it's quite similar to the computable presentations, computable structures, and so on. And if a structure is punctual, we can say in general, we can just restrict our algorithms further. We can consider we can consider any complexity class, for example, p time algorithms, and then so we just replace here in the definition primitive recursive by polynomial time computable functions and so on, and then we say that the structure is punctually C. So it's so punctual class is sufficiently big, it contains many classes, but unfortunately, the theory for polynomial time, punctual structure, and so on, is at that time is not so deep. We have some sufficiently rich results for generally punctual computability, but for t time, we have. Sometimes we have similar results, sometimes not. So, for simple results, usually it is a common behavior that the results which says that something is punctual, something has a punctual copy, usually can be strange that in fact it's a polynomial time, for example. As in this theorem, it's just a collection of theorems collected in one statement. So in fact, we know that many natural structures. In fact, can be transformed to punctual, to a punctual presentation. For example, equivalent structures, linear orders, torsion-free abelian groups, Boolean algebras, abelian groups, and so on. It's sufficiently old results. It's just the results from the time when we started to study this topic. It's me, Alexander Melnikov, and Selvin Enge. So in fact, these results can be, in fact, hold for punctual presentations in P time, and probably even more strict classes. So it is, so it's log space probably, but I don't remember. But polynomial time is absolutely, it's true. So for polynomial time, this is also true. And but we know also that some structures still cannot be transformed from computable to punctual. So it is, in fact, this is some different area of study. So a computable, so some structures can have a computable copy, but they do not have punctual presentations. So, for example, it was not so evident that undirected graphs can be computable but not punctual. So, because it's some naive strategy to build such an example will be breached. It's something, there are some little trick here to construct such undirected graph, which has no punctual presentations. It means that this graph should not contain some easy part. So it, for example, it does not have many elements which are not disconnected with all other elements, and so on. If otherwise, we can contain build a punctual presentation. But in fact, we can build some. You can use some tricks to construct such undirected graph, which have no punctual presentation. And it was an important example because it was probably first example of relational language. Usually these examples are functional. It's abelian groups, so they have some functional symbols. And here we have no functions, only one binary predicate. And so it was important to have this result. I did not notice that, in fact, in contrast with the computability, here we emphasize on relations and operations. In the classic computable model theory, we can reduce all operations to relay all operations to relations and can consider on relational structures. Here it is something different. Relational structures are some specific structures. They are not universal. And so this is just a basic for a basic notion of punctual structures. And now I also forgot to mention that in fact it is a difficult problem to understand which computable structures has a punctual presentation, which has no. So in fact it is it's also recent result of Bazhenov, Harrison Trenov, me, Melnikov, and Enge. In fact, this index set, in fact, which contains the indices of the computable structures, which has a functional representation. It's hard as it is given by the definition. It's sigma 1-1 complete. You cannot omit the quantifier on functional quantifier. So it is, in fact, it's a difficult problem, but it's not the main topic of my talk. I will speak about the categoricity. Here we also, it's not absolutely similar definition with the computable categoricity, because primitive recursive functions are not inversible. Some functions can be primitive recursive, but the inverse, but its inversion is not primitive recursive. So we require here that when we say that A and B are punctually isomorphic, that the isomorphism between A and B must be primitive recursive, and the inverse isomorphism also must be primitive recursive. And punctually categorical means that A is punctually isomorphic to every its punctual presentation. So it is almost the same, but with this difference that we require both P and P minus one be primitive recursive. It can be found something unexpected that, in fact, it's very restrictive notion, in fact. In contrast with the computable categoricity. So what examples we have? Of course, the structure in an empty language is a trivial structure. And of course, it is punctual categorical because any isomorphism, any permutation, any bijection is an isomorphism. But what about the very easy structure? It's the set of natural numbers and the operations plus one. It's not punctual categorical. Maybe I will draw a little bit here. What is the idea? Why? What is the intuition? Why it is partial? It's not categorical. So it is a structure like that. It's we always can fix one standard copy where everything is known and so on. But of course, it's a punctual structure, but it's not punctually categorical because why it is not? So we can fix the beginning, of course. Let us even it's a zero, it's no matter. But after zero, it's some other elements. So x1, we do not know what. We know only that this operation is primitive recursive. Primitive recursive means that it's fast enough. It cannot. It cannot be delayed. So here we use only primitive recursion and composition in the algorithm. So it is means that. That in natural algorithmic language, it means that we can only four operator for loops, not while and repeat and so on. So what we know? We know that some copy, isomorphic copy of this structure is primitive recursive. So we can point one to zero to zero, this one to one, and so on. But it can happen that one, in fact, the in this structure is somewhere here. And we know only that we need fastly, without any delay, to define the image for one, but where it must be. So we know we can calculate some another elements, but no any information is given. We do not have any information just to define the image. To define the image correctly, we need to wait for when one will be generated from zero. So only when we will see after maybe 1 million stages that that one is generated from zero. Yeah? And then we only then we can correctly define 1 to 1 million, for example. But in general, with primitive recursive functions, we cannot you cannot do such a primitive recursive isomorphism. And it's easy to build, in fact, using some diagonalization method, to just to build some copy of this simple structure, which is not primitively, in fact, which is not primitively recursively isomorphic to this standard copy. And in fact, this strategy this can be considered as a pattern. In many structures, we can argue a similar way. So we can have the structure can contain some, as we call this island, which is looks like an island for a, for some time, and this will allow us to break some isomorphism. So we will delay just connecting if it is zero. So this because the structure is too uniform, we can do it. So it is one typical example, a very which can be happen very oftenly. And another surprising example is the ordering of rational numbers. It's also computably categorical structures. The easiest probably example. It is computably categorical, but it is not punctually categorical. But the reason is a little bit different. So again, we can fix a standard copy of this ordering, and now we. For arbitrary copy A, we will have obstacles in other directions. Before we had difficulties mapping to the standard copy. Here, there is no problem just to put any first element to somewhere here. And one is in the right to from zero, we point to somewhere here. If two is somewhere here, then we just we know everything about Q, and so mapping in this direction is not difficult for primitive recursion. Because we just read the information where new element is located and map it correctly. We can generate in Q. We can generate a new rational between two given rationals. But in fact, the difficulty is in the other directions. Of course, we can map zero to zero. It's one, but what about one? Even here, we will have a difficulty. One must be greater than zero, so we must map it somewhere here. But it can be that a structure A, in fact, is constructed very non-standard. Any elements which you can observe can be in the left from zero, on the left side. And we will know, and we will, in fact, we must use the minimization operation just to wait for a first element which is appeared here, but it can be very long. And again, you can use this consideration as a pattern, breaking any isomorphism from the standard copy to some dense linear ordering A, which is itself as an or as an ordering, it's primitive recursive. So again, it can be it's very easily it can be proved that it's not punctually categorical. So we have, in fact, only very trivial example. And the question which we studied initially, it was, are there any non-trivial examples of punctually categorical structure, non-trivial, not just empty language or something similar. And in fact, if you consider some specific class of structures, then we will see, you can see that only trivial examples are present. So for example, rigid relational structures is punctually categorical only if it is finite. An equivalent structure is punctually categorical if it is trivial. So it is just up to finitely many finite equivalence classes, it's a one big equivalence class or infinitely many one element equivalence classes. A linear ordering is, cannot be punctually categorical if it is infinite. A Boolean algebra, the same torsion free abelian groups, also it's only zero. So it's only finite. And in fact, this is known for some other classes. I will not list all results, but the maybe this example is quite interesting because for abelian P groups, we have formally not trivial structure. It is infinite sum of ZP for some prime number P. So it is formally it is not trivial, but it's quite trivial nevertheless. So, but it is it's can consider it as vector space of infinite dimension other this field, other this finite field ZP. So, and because the field is finite, we can just map. If we have two copies of this vector space, we can just find a basis by the standard way in one copy and in another copy, and just map the basis. And using this correspondence, we can extend it to the isomorphism. So it is very easy arguments. Explaining why it is computably categorical or punctually categorical. So this is another example saying that, but it is a more difficult result. In fact, it's published last year. For undirected graphs, it's a combinatorial proof showing that undirected graph is punctually categorical only if it is trivial. So it is up to some finitely many elements, it's a clique or anti-clique. And for this finite part, also it's necessary that it's, of course, each element of of this finite part must be either adjacent with the elements or the rest or not adjacent. So, but it just means that it is trivial. So it is means that almost every permutation is marked. And it's still a problem. I guess it is a quite difficult combinatorial problem to argue that this result holds for arbitrary relation structure. Then the combinatorial, as I afraid, the combinatorial consideration it's will be a huge enough. So making the situation very unclear how to prove it. But I believe that this must be true. So it is only trivial relational structure can be punctually categorical. But it depends from a huge combinatorial consideration. Another restrictions to the punctual categorical structures appeared just very recently in conversations with Sasha Melnikov, and it is very surprisingly that it is it was not known from the beginning. In fact, every punctual structure, a punctual categorical structure, is either locally finite or finitely generated. So we have some dichotomy. There is no something between. Either the structure is generated from a finitely many elements, or any finitely many elements generate a finite substructure. So if the structure is not finitely generated, but there is some finite part which generates an infinite substructure, then the structure must not be, they cannot be primitive, punctually critical. And it is interesting that all examples for each possibility was known in our first paper. So there is a finitely generated punctual categorical structure. So it's the first structure, first non-trivial example of functional categorical structure was a finitely generated structure, and its most simple example was finitely generated. It's more difficult to construct a locally finite example, but again, it is possible, and even we proved that such structure can be even not computably categorical. We know that finitely generated must be computably categorical, but so if the structure is punctually categorical but not computably categorical, it cannot be finitely generated. And by the previous result, it must be locally finite. But it's exactly it was constructed by locally finite automatic. And, to build such examples, it's a special technique was introduced to satisfy the punctual categoricity requirement. I will not say about this technique in details, but in fact this technique is very productive. It is many new results appeared using this technique. For example, also it is recent, it's the result of last year, probably published last year. This is a structure with two punctual copies, A and B, which are not punctually isomorphic, such that any other punctual copy C is punctually isomorphic either to A or B. So it's like a punctual dimension too. So it's possible. But I will not speak about all possible application of this technique. I will say mostly about the external part of this technique, just about the algebraic properties of this, mainly about the finitely generated example. In fact, this structure is built as a finitely generated structure with a generator A, and with two unary operations, and S and T, defined by following equations. Again, I should draw a little bit about so it's so the main difficulty is just to avoid the situation like that. Here we have islands which can be connected anytime. So for opponent it was not difficult just to prepare some island and just grow it. And because the structure is too uniform, it can connect it to any place. Here you should avoid this. And by this reason, the structure is like that. It contains loops of different size. So it is, it's the function T. Functions T is just separates all the universe into finite loops of different size. It's F, it's T. And the size of the first loop is F0, F1, F2, and so on. F is some function, which can be here, for beginning, it's just any function. And S is just connected into one line. So S map first loop into some specific element or the first loop, or the second loop. S maps the second loop, all elements of the loop, into some specific element of the second loop, and so on. So it's a structure like that. And here, if we find some appropriate function, which can be it can be very complicated. It can be 0, 10, 5, 100, and so on. And using this information, at least there is a hope that opponent cannot successfully prepare some islands which can be joined into the main part in any place, in arbitrary place. So it is at least we see that for such structure, may have no chance to prove that the structure is not functional equilibrium. So formally, so it is a function UF. Let us denote this by UF. This can be defined for any function, for any which is just F is just a function which gives the sizes of loops. So it's exactly this. This picture is written on algebraic language. So it means that it's a SNA is just first element of the it's nth loop, and here it is written that it's in fact its loop. I see it is written that S maps arbitrary element of the loop to the some specific element of the next loop. So, and it can be it can be shown easily that any element of our structure is Tm, T to M, S to N from A. So it is some canonical form. And M, in fact, can be lesser radical, strictly lesser than Fn. So all elements of the structure is Tm, Sn, A. And which functions can be considered for punctual computability. The structure UF has a punctual presentations if and only if the graph of F is primitive recursive. It's very easy to show. And in fact, this notion is old. I found these notions in sufficiently old papers. Functions with a primitive recursive graph is called Honneth. So we can do it not even for primitive recursive functions. So the Honneth function can be even not primitive recursive itself, but the graph of the function must be primitive recursive to have a punctual copy of UF. And using our technique, it's possible to show that there is a primitive recursive function F such that where F is punctually categorical. And I do not know how, what is this property that UF is punctually categorical, just on the language of the functions. I cannot reformulate it easily. In fact, I guess the most simple way to describe it is just to say that this specific structure is punctually categorical, but it's interesting. Maybe one can find some nice description of such functions as the structure. The loop structure is punctually categorical. I don't know, but we know that such functions exist. And I will use only this fact, not the proof of existence of such. What consequence we can get? The first consequence which can be seen trivial. I started to think about just from the beginning when this theorem was proved, but I didn't think about deeply. I thought that it is easier and true. Here we have one generator and two unary functions. Why we cannot code it into this semi group? S and T is unary functions. They can be they have a composition operations, the group operations, in fact, semi group operations, in fact, there. A as some unary, it's a constant function, in fact. It's a constant and it can be considered as also as unary operation. And these unary operations under compositions satisfy this property, which we can just to write down and just to consider the corresponding semigroup defined by this equality. It's almost the same. You can note that it's if you will see on this structure, you can see that it's almost the same as previous unary structure. So let UF is punctually categorical. Can we say this that this semigroup defined by this equation is again punctually categorical? Now here I add this equality because A can be viewed as a constant. So it is, in fact, if it's a constant function, then it's it gives this constant with composition with any other function. But in fact, it is not. I was surprised that after 2 or 3 years that it's not, because if you consider this semigroup, it has a generator S and T as elements, and they generate a free semigroup, in fact, as a substructure, as sub semigroup. And this substructure is too uniform. We again can build some irons here and proving that the structure is not punctually categorical, even that the words containing A, everything is fine. The structure, the elements of this semigroup containing A, it's almost, it's exactly the same as the previous struct. They act as exactly as UF. But for this part, you cannot do it. But nevertheless, maybe I wrote somebody that it's true. I do not know, but for any case, I was afraid that it's not true, and I tried to prove it that at least such semigroup exists. This is hopefully true. The idea here is that if we look on these equalities, first and two, we see that the number of S is the same in the left and in the right part of equality. So S letters cannot be disappear or appear. So in all transformations under these equations, the number of S must be the same. So what's the idea? I just prepared two constants. Here I had one constant, A. I introduce it to the second similar constant, B. But B now, the B part is the same, similar to A part, but S and T changed the role. Instead of S, we have T. Instead of T, we have S. So it is S and T are changed and vice versa. And now, we can prove that the structure, it's a semigroup, I do not say this as SF, is punctually categorical. The idea is just again so A part, if the word contains A, then it's similar. It's it can be in this part we can construct some copy of S of UF. Here we again can build some copy of the structure of UF and using the information that the structures UF is punctually categorical, we can argue that this part and this part are independently punctually categorical. So we can recognize the elements of A part and B part, but not the word which do not contain A and B. For this, and now we can, using the fact that in the A in the equations with A, the S is preserved, we can obtain the number of S here. And using the fact that here must be B, not A. I forgot to change. It's here. It is B. The number of T in the B part is again is preserved. And so we know. For the word W, we know the number of S and number of T in the word T, and now it's enough just to brute force, just to search all possible words from the generators, seeing just waiting when one of such words equal to W, And because the number of S and T is already computed, it's again, it's a bounded search. And so, and here, even here, we of course cannot have some polynomial time or something like that. We do some long search for it. But it's but it is primitively recursively bounded. So this idea and it works. So there are semi groups which are partially categorical. And so now I want to say about the functional categoricity, degrees of functional categoricity. But first, I need to say what is the reducibility. F is primitively recursively reducible to G, it's a very naturally defined as it is written. If F can be obtained from the basic primitive recursive functions and G as external function by composition and primitive recursion. It's just, in fact, it's a very, it's a reduction, it's a reducibility, it generates some equivalence classes. And these equivalence classes are called functional degree. And the purpose of this reducibility is just to consider degrees of categoricity and to study categoricity on the cone in the end of my talk. And it's a basic properties. I should say that graph F is not the same as the function F. So it is graph is reduced to function. And this reducibility, it's some reducibility stronger than truth table reducibility. It's just a note. Partial degrees of categoricity defined exactly as a degree of computable categories. But again, we need to require that the function and the inverse, the isomorphism at the inverse must be primitive recursively reduced to X instead of just primitive recursive. So as such is X punctually categorical if A is X punctually isomorphic to every its punctual presentation. And the degree X is the degree of punctual categoricity of A if it's the least degree such that A is functionally categorical in this degree. So it is a standard definition. And here it's an example how you can use the construction above just to find some, find infinitely many different degrees of punctual categories. It's just enough to consider two honest functions, f and g. F is from the previous result, so uf must be punctually categorical, and g is any, maybe not primitive recursive, it's just any honest function. So the graph must be primitive recursive, but g can be, for example, it can be Ackermann function. And then, if you consider this kind, this type of the join, you can join two functions by different way. But I select this one. I need to have one very oftenly on all. On all elements which are divided by three, it's just to it's just to fastly recognize F and G part in the structures U of the type U. So, and in fact, it's possible to show that the structure U of the type U, you've coded functions F times G, is has the degree of punctual categoricity X. And the same can be shown for a thing. So any honest degree is a degree is a degree of functional category. So in fact, this result is again from 2017, but at that time we didn't notice that one can prove the vice versa. A functional degree is a degree of functional categoricity of functional finitely generated structure, if and only if it contains a honest function. So here we get a full description of functional degrees of of finitely generated structures. So for finitely generated structures, it's only honest degrees. So the degrees of the functions with primitive recursive graph can be such a degree. We code into the isomorphisms only such functions. And the natural question: can a non-honest functional degree be a functional degree of categoricity of functional structure? We know only partial answers. So again, we have a dichotomy. Every expansion categorical structure is either locally finite or finitely generated. Everything is known for finitely generated, but so all other examples must be locally finite. And here it is some, also it is was maybe new example. We never had such example, but there is a punctual degree X. So some structure can be, in fact, expunctionally categorical for some bounded function, for some bounded degree. It's not a degree of honest function. Honest function is, if it is not primitive recursive, it's unbounded. But the structure itself is not punctually categorical. So it is, so maybe our answer is yes, but I do not know. And the rest of my talk is devoted to the functional categoricity on a cone. It's again, we can say it using our reduction, our reducibility, primitive recursive reducibility. We say that, and again, it's these notions, it's similar to the computable categoricity on a cone. An infinite structure A punctually categorical on a cone if there is a function H, it's some big oracle such that every copies B and C of A on the domain N is isomorphic in this oracle. H is a fixed oracle plus B, it's all functions and relations in B. And here it is all functions and relations in C. It's exactly if we replace the word punctual to computable, it will be exactly a computable category. But here we just again require that the isomorphism and its inverse must be below this order, must be reducible to this order. If this external oracle H is zero, is or primitive recursive, if A is punctual itself, then we can say that A is relatively punctually categorical. Again, what examples we have? Trivial examples, so the structures where any permutation is an automorphism up to some finitely many element, or this example of abelian group of this form. It's formally it is not trivial, but nevertheless it's quite simple. So of course if we will look on the construction of this punctual categorical structure, we can note that they are not categorical on a cone, because here we satisfy requirements for each punctual presentation. So we, it's countably many requirements which we for each possible punctual presentations we produce primitive recursive isomorphism which we built it by a special construction. So it is so this is not an example. So so for a while we only have these examples. So it is trivial examples and abelian groups, maybe something similar, but not something more difficult. this results is submitted in an also student applied logic. So it is so it contains these results. So a relational structure is punctually categorical on a cone if it is relatively punctually categorical only if it is trivial. So so for relational structure we exactly have only trivial example. So and this is it's an informal argument to that to the questions which I listed somewhere here. So this is true for usual punctual categoricity. This is true only for graphs, for example, but we do not know for relational. On a cone, this is true. And for arbitrary structures, the situation is more difficult. Of course, if we try to describe it, we know that punctual categorical must be computably categorical on a cone. So it, it must be a Scott family of existential formulas over A, over some finite or some finite tuple of elements. A must be omega categorical. So, so and it's natural because, for example, otherwise without this property, any finitely generated structure or such as omega chain, for example, will satisfy. It is computably categorical. So, but the omega chain is exactly an example of a structure which is not omega categorical. And so it is locally finite, and moreover, there is some uniform bound on the elements generated from some elements. So, so if you know that, for example, five elements in this tuple, you know that these five elements cannot generate more than F from five elements. And again, we know an examples of omega categorical structures which are not punctually categorical. It's the ordering of rationals. And so the third, so we need one more property describing the full situation, the punctual categoricity on the cone. But it's quite difficult. We do not know how to simplify it. It looks like it's totally categorical, but we do not cannot prove it or something like to do something more easy. But what it says is a certain notion that for every b tuple b there is some n such that every n tuple c, so the tuple of n elements of pairwise distinct elements, the substructure ABC, so it's all elements together, generates the substructure containing elements of each automorphism orbit over AB. So it is it's recorded, and I guess I can try the slides if necessary, but it's quite difficult just for myself. It's difficult to just to understand it from the beginning. It's something difficult notion. It should be carefully studied just to understand what it means. But nevertheless, the theorem is gives a full description, but also it is it does not give any description for relative categories. That's all. Thank you. Thank you for the attention. This is the end of my talk.
Thanks, Iskander. Thanks. Are there any questions? If so, just unmute yourself and ask.
So maybe I'll ask about the when you do get the on a cone punctual categoricity, you have is it somehow a forcing proof like the
it's
relative categoricity for.
Yes, it's a forcing proof, but nevertheless, the forcing here is, I do not know why it is, it's much, much difficult than usual computable of computability force. I do not know why it's, there are some specific, we expected that forcing arguments together with primitive recursive functionals must be more simple, but sometimes they present more difficult problems than usual standard computable forcing proof, for example, for the proof for computable categoricity on the cone. It's more difficult. I don't know why. But itself, this notion, in fact, it's and even here, it is there are some tricks here just to describe the punctual categoricity. It's sometimes you see the basic model of the. Basic model for generalization using forcing is simple. It's and the idea is clear, but when you need to proceed some structure, and the, you constructing structure, you need to do something. You should do something without a delay, building some structure. And the difficulty here is just to correctly extend the structures and do not lose and satisfying the. So the main difficulty is here, it's the structure is not rigid. If the structure is rigid, it's more or less, it's simple proofs. When the structure is not rigid, when then there are many confusing situations when some is automorphic, when looking for some non-trivial automorphism, which will can kill everything. It's difficult, right? Yeah, and unexpected, in fact.
Any more questions? Comments? Anything? Okay, if not, I'll stop the recording.